There's something really surprising about these age distributions, which is these ones are clustered very close to 18, whereas these are all over the place, really far from 18 in most cases. So can we characterize this somehow? I would say the mode, the median, or the mean don't really capture the spread of the data. What does capture the spread is called the variance. So now we'll compute the variance of the data. And the very first trick we apply is we normalize these sequences by subtracting the mean from each data item. So in the case of the friends, if we subtract 18 from 17, we get minus 1, 1, 0, minus 1, 1. If we subtract 18 from this data sequence, we get minus 11, 20, minus 14, 5, and 0. If you compute the mean of these two sequences, then you find the mean in both cases is 0, and I spare you the work. And the reason is by subtracting the mean from every single data item, we took it out of the equation and we arrive at 0. But what's now really interesting is that these numbers are much closer to 0 than these numbers over here. So the spread over here is much larger. Now you might think in computing the variance, you just add up all these values and you get a measure of the spread. But the truth is it doesn't work. If you add them up, they're actually 0. So we have to add up something else. And what's commonly added up are the squares of those values. The squares here are 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Whereas over here, they're 121, 400, 196, 25, and 0. So for the variance, we sum the squares of all these numbers and normalize that. But the squares are not taken of the original data. They're taken of the original data minus the mean, which I'm going to write by this Greek letter over here, mu. So do me a favor and try to compute the variance for the first sequence, which you obtain by adding those squares over here and dividing them by 5.